We're in Los Angeles, California for what should be an exciting football game. And we couldn't have asked for better weather for today's game between the Notre Dame Fighting Irish and the USC Trojans. And here come the Trojans. Welcome, everybody. Brad Nessler here for EA Sports with my co-host Kirk Herbstreit and Lee Corso. We hope you're ready for an action-packed game of NCAA football. Neither team seems to have an advantage in this game. Kirk, how about your prediction?
Well, this one's going to come down to whoever can make the big plays. USC needs to get the ball in the hands of their athletes. That means getting their running back maybe 25 or 30 touches today. If they do that, Lee, they'll take care of business.
I like that pick, and I'm going to tell you why. USC can run the football against anybody, and this defense will be no different. Watch them. They'll bang them and bang them and bang them.
We'll see how this game plays out as they get ready for the opening kickoff. Kicks it off. Number 27 fields it at the 7. They'll get the ball here at the 24-yard line.
Set. Cut hot. Cut hot. Cut. Cut hot.
Setting up the play action. Got it to his receiver. And down he goes. A good play fake that time.
Here, the play action was key. It held the linebackers there by the fake by the running back, and the running back did a very nice job of carrying out his fake.
And the quarterback did a tremendous job with the fake handoff, too.
First and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. Nickel defense. And he's taken down. A gain of 1. It's second down and 9 to go. Ball on their own 37. USC lines up with 3 receivers. Drops back to pass. He steps up across the middle at the 40. He's got it. He goes down. Looks like someone was called for holding.
Holding on the offense. 10-yard penalty.
He held him back, and he got called for it.
Yeah, he knew he had missed his block, and all he wanted to do was slow him down somehow. But the ref was right there and made the call.
Second and long coming up here. Ball on the 27. Notre Dame lines up in a dime defense here. Steps up down the middle and got it complete. So they pick up quite a few yards on that play, Kirk.
Well, that was an excellent route, and he did a great job of holding on to the football.
It's third down and 9 to go. Ball on the 37. The Irish bring in their dime package. Back to pass. Steps up in the pocket. He almost had the completion.
Yeah, but the defense was ready and were able to get a hand on the pass and bring up fourth down.
Fourth and 9. Ball on the 37-yard line.
They come out in a punt formation. He gets it away. Number 33 takes it to the 21. He's hit and got away. And they take over after a nice punt return. They'll take over at the 36. The Irish come out of the power eye. They'll run the option. And down he goes. And a good play there.
Here they give it to the fullback on the option, and the big guy gets good yardage.
Yep, good yardage and a first down.
First and 10. Ball right around midfield. He'll work the left side. And he's taken down. Pickup of a yard for the tailback. Second and 9 coming up here. Ball right around midfield. Number 44 alone in the backfield. They keep it on the ground with the tailback. And down he goes at the 44. They got 4 yards on that one. It's third down and 5 to go. Ball on the 44. The Irish line up in the power eye formation. They go with the option. He fakes a pitch, and he's taken down. They don't pick up the first on that play.
Brad, that defense is saying, not so fast, my friend. You're not going to run that ball that easy.
Number 9 set to punt. He punts it. Number 14 signals for a fair catch. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. Time once again for this offense to come back out and start another drive. First and 10. Ball on the 20. The Trojans line up in a split back set. Begins to the fullback, and down he goes at the 22-yard line. And there's a penalty on the play. Let's see who it's on.
Holding on the offense. 10 yards from the spot of the foul.
And that penalty's going to push him back.
Yeah, an offense can't be productive when they're making mistakes like that.
It's first and a mile. Ball on the 11-yard line. The Trojans go with the I formation. He steps up. He's got the fullback. And he's taken down. Pretty good gain right there.
You know, the thing that impresses me about this offense is their ability to spread the ball around. They're not afraid to go to their tight ends, their tailbacks, and in this case, their fullback. Nicely designed play.
Here it is again. Second and 9. Ball on the 21-yard line. The Trojans come out in the ace formation. On the ground with the tailback. And down he goes at the 27. The running back gives him 6 on the ground. It's third down and 3 to go. Ball on the 27-yard line. And that's the end of the quarter. We're scoreless after one. We've got third and three here. Ball on their own 27. The Trojans line up in a goal line formation. And they hit him in the backfield.
They didn't have the ball long there.
Having ball control is important in football. And three and out is what you want to avoid for sure.
The drive stalls, and they'll have to punt it away. He gets it off. Number 33 fields it at the 38. At the 40. The offense comes back on the field, hoping to build off their last drive.
You know, they had something going, but were unable to get any points.
Excellent field position to start the drive. The Trojans line up with six defensive backs. They'll throw on first down. Incomplete.
It looks like he overthrew him on that one.
I'll tell you, I think the quarterback got rid of that one too quickly, Kirk.
Well, Coach, you're right. They need to work on their timing a little bit more.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 31-yard line. The Trojans line up in a nickel back. He drops back. Rolls to the left. And it falls incomplete. A little too much juice on that one.
And this quarterback sometimes gets a little bit too excited back there and tries to put too much on it. He's got to relax and just make a good throw.
Third and 10. Ball on the 31. Number 44, the lone back. Drops back to pass. Steps up. Over the middle. Got it. And he's taken down at the 20-yard line. They pick up solid yardage there.
Yeah, nice little pitch and catch there. The wideout was able to find a little open space in the defense. And the quarterback was able to get him the ball for a good pickup.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 20. Back to pass. Steps up in the pocket. Complete. And down he goes. And Kirk, that was a nice grab there.
You know, it may be simple, but whenever you can gain solid yardage, you're doing something right.
Second and 6, and this is the fifth play of the current drive. USC brings in the nickel here. Drops back. He steps up across the middle. Incomplete pass. He missed his man there.
Yeah, he's got to be a little bit more patient down there, close to the end zone.
Offense faces another third down as they line it up. The Fighting Irish with four receivers. And he's taken down. Well, they tried to keep it on the ground for the first down.
You know, Brad, here the defense just steps up and makes a play, stopping them and bringing up fourth down.
Number 98 lines up for the field goal. The kick is up. And it sails right on him. No good. First and 10. Ball on their own 20. And down he goes at the 20. This one might be coming back, folks. Let's check out the penalty.
Got an inadvertent face mask on the defense. 5-yard penalty, second down.
You got a hold of the face mask there.
Yeah, Brad, you have to be careful when wrapping up on a guy like that.
It's second down and 5 to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. The Trojans line up with 3 wide. They hand it off. He tries to spin, and he's taken down. Picked up a yard of anything on that run. 1 yard gain on the play. Third down and 4 coming up on this one. Ball on their own 26. The Irish bring in the nickel package. Fumble, loose ball. They'll drop him for a loss. Notre Dame calls a timeout, and they've got 2 remaining. So they're set to punt this one away. Punts the ball away. Number 33 fields it at the 41. At the 40. A heck of a return there.
What I like here is they now have decent field position to work with.
They'll set up shop at the 33-yard line. The Irish come out in the ace formation. Gets the ball. No, they faked it. Got it. And down he goes. And a pretty smart call right there.
You're absolutely right. The reason why this play worked is that the play action froze the defense just enough to allow the receiver to get open.
First and 10. Ball on the 21. Drops back to pass. Steps up. Wants to throw outside. It falls incomplete. A little too much muscle behind that pass. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 21-yard line. Back to pass. Steps up in the pocket. Finds his receiver. He's knocked out of bounds. And Herbie, that was a good-looking throw.
Yeah, and what impresses me is the composure of this young quarterback. He made a great read, saw the open receiver, and delivered an almost perfect strike. Good-looking play.
Number 2 comes to the line with 3 wide. And he's taken down. The Fighting Irish are going to take a timeout. And now they've only got 1 remaining. The middle. Touchdown, Fighting Irish. How do you like that? They give it to the fullback.
I like that. I like that a lot. That's a good call around the goal line.
And there's no way the defense was going to stop that guy. He was going to get in the end zone no matter what. He was determined.
And he hits the PAT. Less than a minute remains in the second quarter, and our score is Notre Dame 7, USC nothing. Number 98 ready to kick, number 27 and number 24 back ready to return. Number 24 fielded at the 13. And now we'll see the offense come out onto the field for their next possession. They'll start this drive at the 23. USC lines up in a bunch formation, and it's caught, and down he goes. The Trojans call for a timeout, and they'll have two remaining. It's first and 10, ball on the 34-yard line. The Trojans line up in a split back set. He drops back. He steps up across the middle. Oh, he had the pick and he dropped it. The quarterback really lucked out there.
I thought they had a chance for an interception, but I'm sure they'll settle for the incompletion. It still was a good play.
Second and 10. Ball on the 34. USC lines up with three receivers. Drops back to pass. Steps up under pressure. Throws this one out to the left. Got it. At the 40. Sheds that one. Inside the 30. To the 10. And he will score. The wideout makes a big catch there.
Hey, whenever you have a receiver who can make plays like that, you just want to get the ball in his hands and let him do the work.
Listen up, my friend. That was a tremendous throw by the quarterback, too. Don't forget about the guy swinging the ball away.
And he tacks on the extra point. Less than a minute remains in the second quarter, and our score is USC 7, Notre Dame 7. All lined up and ready for the kickoff. Short kick. He didn't get a hold of that one. Number 13 takes from the 10. Thanks to some nice passing on the last drive, the offense was able to take it down the field for 6.
And great play calling to help make that an easy drive. The question is, can they do it again?
They'll go to work at the 24. The Trojans line up in a nickelback. They'll throw on first down. Steps up in the pocket. Finds his receiver, and he's hammered down. The defense looked a little lost on that one, Kirk.
Yeah, they did, Brad. Nice recognition here by the quarterback to see that confusion and then take advantage.
They'll throw on first down. And they couldn't hook up on that one. He needed a little more touch on his throw.
He's got to take a deep breath, relax, and just play a little pitch and catch out there. Don't be anxious, kid.
So it's second and 10. Ball on their own 36. The Fighting Irish come out showing 3 wide. Back to pass. He's got to throw it in a hurry. Throws this one out to the left. Incomplete. And he led his receiver a little too much.
One of the things you look for when you have a young quarterback is how he releases the football. Here you can see he releases the ball a little bit early, a sign that he wasn't completely comfortable with what he was seeing.
Third down and 10 coming up. Ball on the 36-yard line. USC brings in their nickel package. He drops back. He steps up, looks, fires deep down the left side, and it's incomplete.
Kirby just let that one get away from him.
Yeah, and you can see he wants that one back. That's a throw this guy can make in his sleep.
They line up to punt this one away. Number 9 gets it off. Number 46 takes it to 25.
He almost broke it there.
Like you said, Coach, one more block and that could have been 6.
They'll take over at the 38. And I think they're going to take one last shot at the end zone here. They'll throw on first down. Steps up. Home run ball in the air. Oh, boy, almost intercepted. That'll do it for the first half here. We're tied as the players head to the locker room. USC got the ball to start the game, so they'll be kicking off to start the second half. Here's the kick. Number 13 takes it at the 12. And now a slight break in the action as the offense comes out onto the field for their next possession. They'll set up shop at the 32-yard line. Notre Dame goes with the ace set here. They keep it on the ground with a tailback. Spins upfield, and he's taken down. That'll be a 7-yard pickup. Second and 3. Ball on the 39-yard line. Tries to juke, and down he goes at the 47. He's not just a big lumbering guy out there.
Yeah, he is. He's a big lumbering guy with some speed. Good-looking run for the first and 10.
It's first and 10. Ball on their own 47. For a loss. Good play there by the defense.
This is just a toss to the tailback, but the defense gets a good read on his play and was able to stop him for a loss.
Second and long. Ball on the 41. Number 2 has 4 receivers lined up here. Bad snap from center. And he's taken down at the 44-yard line. That's a 3-yard pickup. It's third down and 13 to go. Ball on their own 44. Number 44 lines up as a single back. Drops back to pass. Steps up in the pocket, throws, And down he goes. He didn't get the first down.
Hey, fantastic job by the defense there by not allowing to get any yards after the catch.
And the punt team will come out. It's fourth down. Number nine gets it off. He drops it. He just couldn't pull that one in cleanly.
And Brad, that's what happens when you take your eyes off the ball. This was an error that should have been avoided.
They'll start this drive at the 15. Inside handoff. And he's taken down. A 5-yard gain. Second and five coming up here. Ball on the 20. USC lines up with a split backfield. Back to pass. He steps up, wants to throw outside. And it's the fullback with a catch. How about that pass, Kirk?
You know, guys, one of the things often overlooked in college football is the relationship between a quarterback and his receiver. Here, you can see that these two are definitely on the same page.
First and 10. Ball on the 36-yard line. The Trojans line up with three wide. He drops back. Steps up under heavy pressure. They'll make the sack. They were bringing a heavy rush on that one.
Brad, that's what happens if the quarterback holds the ball too long, waiting for his receivers to get open.
It's second down and a long ways to go. Ball on the 29. Number 28 is the deep back as they line up in the eye. Drops back to pass. Across the middle. Got it. And down he goes. A nice completion there.
Yeah, and I'll tell you what, that defense has got to adjust their coverage a little bit. They can't continue to let this happen.
Lee, you're right. They've got to mix it up. Try to confuse the timing of this offense.
First and 10. Ball on the 49. Three wideouts here. Gets the ball. No, they faked it. Got it to his receiver. Inside the 30. To the 10. And he's all the way in for the touchdown. What a display of pure speed.
Now, anytime this guy touches the ball, he has the ability to go the entire length of the field with that speed.
And if I was calling plays, I would say, go run past everybody and report it to you. He can.
He hits the PAT. Less than a minute remains in the third quarter with the score USC 14, Notre Dame 7. Number one, ready to kick. Number 13 and number 28 set to return. Short kick, he didn't get a hold of that one. Number 28 fields it at the 13. So the offense takes over, and they'll try to figure out this defense. They forced them to punt the last time they had the ball. They'll go to work at the 35-yard line. USC brings in the nickel here. Play action. He passes it. Big opening. Sheds a tackler. Inside the 30 to the 20. And they tackle him. This quarterback doesn't seem to be having any trouble with the zone, does he?
He recognized the receiver was behind the coverage and he found him with a perfect strike. That's nice passing for a first down.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 13. Ace backfield. They keep it on the ground with a tailback. And he's taken down at the 7-yard line. 6 yards on the carry. And that's the end of the third quarter. Our score in this one, USC 14, Notre Dame 7. He drops back, steps up in the pocket, makes a catch in the end zone, touchdown, and a nice catch by the receiver for the touchdown.
Anytime you're near the red zone, you got to keep an eye for this guy. They love going to him down here.
And he tacks on the extra point. So with under 5 minutes to go here in the fourth, the score, Notre Dame 14, USC 14. Number 98 looks ready to kick this one off. Number 27 and number 24 back to return. Number 27 fields it at the 9. At the 30. Now we see the offense come out of the field.
And you know who's trembling right now? That defensive secondary.
The secondary should be trembling after all the yards that they gave up that last time.
They'll take over at the 31-yard line. They come out with three wide receivers. On the ground, up the middle. And down he goes. And he pulls off a great run.
Let me tell you something. This kid is a good running back, and I haven't seen moves like that since my high school prom, sweetheart.
Easy, Coach. You don't want to scare off any of our viewers.
First and 10. Ball on the 42-yard line. They line up with split backs. Inside give. And he's taken down. The fullback gains about 4 yards there. It's second down and 6 to go. Ball on the 46. The Trojans come out with split backs. He'll get the call again. And down he goes at the 48-yard line. The fullback gets a couple on the misdirection. Third and 4. Ball on the 48. The Trojans come out showing 3 wide. Set.
They hand it off. Missed tackle. He's hit hard, and he's taken down. How about that conversion on third down?
You've got to give credit to the offensive line. Good push by the guys up front. They're really working hard down in the trenches.
Let me tell you, the biggest compliment you can give a coach is that his team is playing hard. And you're right. These guys are playing real hard. I mean real hard right now.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 41-yard line. Number 28 lines up in the deep back. Eye formation. He steps up.
Got it.
Here he goes. And they finally knock him out at the 9-yard line. Notre Dame comes out defensively with 6 defensive backs. Steps up. Complete.
Great stiff arm. Touchdown, USC.
And he's turning in a pretty good passing game. That was his 3rd touchdown through the air. That touchdown pass we're seeing again.
Ah, you betcha. He runs a good clean route there, and the quarterback throws it to him with a lot of confidence. Good touchdown, guys.
Hits the PAT. So under 3 minutes to go in the 4th quarter, and the score is USC 21, Notre Dame 14. All lined up and ready for the kickoff. Not a real deep kick, should be returned. Number 28 fields it at the 7. They did a great job on their last drive, moving the ball down the field for a touchdown. Let's see if they can duplicate that on this drive. First and 10. Ball on their own 24. Fullback on the inside give. And down he goes at the 31-yard line. And the fullback busts through for about 7 yards. Second and 3 coming up. Ball on their own 31. Number 44 is the single setback. And he's taken down. And he picked up a first down on that run, Coach.
Yeah, you know, if they pick up a few more first downs on the ground like that, it will really open the play action pass.
First and 10. Ball on their own 38. Notre Dame goes with the ace set here. Steps up in the pocket.
Going deep. Lays it out there.
It falls incomplete. He just couldn't get to that one.
Well, he looked to be a little excited back there in the pocket. May have rushed things a little bit. Needs to be a little bit more patient. Step up. Make the throw.
It's second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 38-yard line. Notre Dame comes out with an eye formation. Here's a counter play. And they got him for a loss.
That didn't go anywhere.
Yeah, I'll tell you why. They were coming with a heavy blitz, and guys were shooting through the line right into the backfield. That play didn't have a chance.
Third down and 10 coming up. Ball on the 38. The Irish line up with 3 wide. He steps up down the middle. Here's an opening. And he's all the way down to the 26. The quarterback broke down the coverage on that one. First down.
When you drop back to pass and see zone, it's a matter of you and the receiver getting on the right page and finding the right window to put the ball through.
Hey, Kirk, that's probably what you did playing in the backyard, right? But you broke a lot of windows, I bet you.
Number two with four wide receivers. He's looking. Throws this one out to the right. He's all the way. Touchdown. And for that young man, it's touchdown catch number two.
Hey, this guy's really stepped up for his football team today.
Well, it's obvious the coach wanted to get him involved in the game plan. It looks like it was a pretty smart move, too.
Tacks on the extra point. So with just over a minute to go here in the fourth quarter, our score, Notre Dame 21, USC 21. Number 98 ready to kick, number 27 and number 24 back deep to return. Number 27 takes it at the 14. Let's see if this defense has trouble defending the pass again here.
If they do, my friend, look out. They're going to give up another touchdown in a hurry.
They'll set up shot at the 30. And they have three receivers bunched. They'll throw on first down. And it falls incomplete. He was looking for his running back, but the pass just sailed on it. So it's second and 10. Ball on the 30-yard line. The Irish bring in their dime package. Steps up. Going deep on the left side. And he's got it! He's all the way down to the 26. The Trojans are going to take a timeout, and they've got two remaining. It's first and 10. Ball on the 26. Ground with the tailback. Bounces off the would-be tackler. And down he goes. The Trojans call for a timeout. That was their second timeout. First and 10. Ball on the 16-yard line. Pro formation here. Little misdirection, and he's taken down at the 12. A 4-yard pickup by the fullback. It's second down and 6 to go. This is the 5th play of this drive. Shakes off a tackle, a little juke. And down he goes. Flags are down, and this one might be on the offense.
Holding on the offense. 10 yards from the spot of the foul.
He grabbed him there.
Second down.
Those kind of penalties are the ones that drive coaches crazy and make them turn red. That's a 10-yard penalty that doesn't need to be committed.
Second and 13 coming up here. Ball on the 19-yard line. USC lines up in a shotgun set. Back to pass. Throws. And he drops it.
It's third down and 13 to go. And this is the sixth play of the drive. Notre Dame brings in the nickel here. He'll get it again. And he's taken down at the 17-yard line. The Trojans are going to take a timeout, and that was their last timeout. They'll call on the field goal unit here. He gets it up. Yes, he made it, and this one is over. And that's the end of the game. Kirk, what'd you think of this one?
I'm sad to see this one end because it was a great game to watch. Notre Dame had plenty of chances to win this football game, but it wasn't meant to be today. All you can do now is try to bounce back after a close loss like this.
Thanks.